My name is Michael Schertz, born and raised in Indiana, and full-time bartending maybe 10 years now, but kind of off and on for almost 15. I had started doing catering and events in Manhattan when I first moved there, and then also was a server, and inevitably there's always a need for a bartender or a service bartender on a busy night. A lot of what I've done in my life is because I just don't sit still well, so I'm always curious to learn and go, and that's kind of how I stumbled into it. What inspires me behind the bar is finding something that I've never heard of and nerding out to it and trying to see how many different ways I can incorporate or manipulate it. I mean, there was a while that I found out about shrubs, and I was like, I'm going to use everything in the back to make a shrub out of whatever they have not nailed back in the kitchen. And sometimes you're like, that's amazing. And sometimes you're like, that's absolutely horrible. But there's always a little win, and I just like to just kind of find something, beat it to death, and then have another thing in my arsenal. So that's one of the things about the restaurant business in general. It's emotionally driven. I mean, you have to have a great product, but people want to connect. They want to feel special, especially behind the bar. If they're sitting at the bar, they can go anywhere to have a cocktail. I mean, but they want to connect. So I've always just keep being curious, keep them relevant. Got my personal training certificate. Had that. Had my little toddler that I'm chasing around like crazy, trying to keep him busy. We're all going through this right now. I mean, we're all going through a crazy time. So find ways to keep you engaged, sane, having fun, whether it's cooking. That's all these are skills that I feel like I incorporate in the bar, because it's all, how can you connect the dots? How can you make something work? You know, personal training is like a puzzle piece. What's off? What can I do to dial that back in? Same thing with a cocktail. You try it and you're like, well, too sweet. It needs maybe a bitter. It needs an herb. It needs something. So just being analytical, critical, you know, for me, I'm always constantly trying to be better. And the nice thing about cocktails is as you're trying to work and get it better, you can actually sip on something at the same time. I've been bar managing here at Amis for almost 3 years now, pretty much literally from the get-go. I started here because of, one, I live here in Westport, so I was actually watching this slowly build and build and build. So I was always kind of in the back of my head being like, And that it's owned by Urban Outfitters. It's pretty genius for someone in the service industry, because you don't always get the benefits of having insurance, 401k, all this. My son was about to be born, and this was great. Plus, they have enough funds to really dump in and keep doing it till it works. You know, that for me was great, because I have so many things I can choose. If I got excited about something, they're like, go ahead and buy a random liqueur or buy something. So that's always been a big benefit as well. And then I personally do this in my own life, but they're really big in the community once they get into an area. And we are all about that with Amis. I mean, that's our whole thing, is it's local, sustainable, organic, incorporating, like our chef is gonna be over at the farmer's market almost every Thursday grabbing stuff. So for me, I like to do that with our drinks as well. What can I source that's now fresh here? And their focus on that, for me, is in alignment with who I am as a person. My favorite thing about bartending, it's funny because I'm a bit more of an introvert. I'm one of those people that just loves to nerd out to things. So it's not to being in front of people, which I love to connect with people and find out what they want and cater something to them. But I love the time I get by myself to just make stuff. I'll like literally make all these funky different, whether it's syrups, shrubs, oleo set cherim, all this stuff, and I'll just make it out of everything in the back by myself and just try, and I need to keep busy and do that. I think it's the opportunities that I've been able to get through it to get in these like closed doors events or places I would never go or be a part of, you know what I mean? And that's for me is exciting. So I was actually started doing really high-end events in Manhattan. So I was at the 50th anniversary Playboy party. It's just insane. I mean, it was one of the beginning things that I had actually done for bartending, where I was almost more of a bar back. I was loading them up and getting them up and drinks if it got too crazy. But I mean, I'm just flying the wall and like watching like Hugh Hefner sit there with all these girls. And so, I mean, it was just every star you could even imagine coming in there. And when you get sometimes, I'm like, I've been to events where Sting is there singing, and like it's 200 people, or, you know, I mean, super intimate. Unless you were spending $1 million to be there or some elite person, you'd never be there. So there's been countless times where I'm like, is this really like, is this actually happening right now? I'm like, yes, it is. All right, you know, and just because I'm making drinks and that gets me an in. So I'm Mike, bar manager at Amis. Enough talking about cocktails. How about we I actually go back and make one with a little cylinder. All right, so the drink we have for today is called Fly a Kite. Been wanting to do something with these little origami kites for a long time, so I thought this was the perfect opportunity. First ingredient we're gonna be playing with is aquafaba. It literally means aqua is water and faba is beans. So it's just chickpea water. It does the same thing as egg whites do. So it's almost like a vegan version for that nice foam that you get on top of your cocktails. So to start it off, we're gonna do 1 ounce of the aquafaba. And to activate the aquafaba, you have to do a dry shake like you would with egg whites. So shake it for about 20 seconds. We're good. Next main ingredient, cylinder. And next, we're gonna be using Italicus. This is a bergamot liqueur. Bergamot, they call it bergamot orange because it's the size of an orange, but it's green. They use it a lot of times in Earl Grey, perfume, so you get this great citrusy note that goes really well in cocktails. And next, classic, but always good, chartreuse. Comes in green and yellow. The yellow is nice, light, felt like really blended well. Chartreuse, a little goes a long way. And next, lemon juice. Never hurts to have a little citrus in the mix when you're making cocktails. A little bit of simple syrup. To bring it all together, and going back to what I was talking about with the lemon notes, we have lemon bitters. Fee Brothers is nice because it's glycerin based. It tends to be light, more fresh than some of those earthy bitters that you can think of with Angostura and some of the other ones. So, just a couple. 1, 2. Now it's ice and shake. And now, the fun part, the pour. As you can see, you get that nice little foam on top, and there's such a light, fluffy texture to the aquafaba, even compared to regular egg white. So, and to finish all off, can't have a good cocktail unless you have a fun garnish. So we have our little blue kites. And there you have it. Go fly a kite. Pretty sure that's social distancing approved, too, so.